They were from a segment of the movement, more generally speaking, called the white anti-imperialists. And in the broadest terms, most easy to understand, they were from Weathermen. If you look at like where they came from in the anti-war movement. And there they were, and we went to something where a representative from Zimbabwe talked about how they just freed the country, where people talked about the women's role in freeing Zimbabwe. And I was so excited, I felt like I'd find my place. One of the kinds of organizing we did at that time was we walked around to laundromats on the Lower East Side, and we talked to people waiting to get their laundry done about buying a dollar for a bullet for SWAPO, and you know, helping to free Africa as part of women's liberation in this country. And in other words, what I would say is that there was a confrontational, very direct style that I admire to this day, that was at times so rhetorical and so removed from the experience of the people we were trying to talk to, that it was sometimes very difficult. On the other hand, another thing we had been sort of tasked to do was to try to shift the white women's movement away from an alliance with the police that was moving into a very kind of, it was moving in a racist direction. It's hard to describe exactly, but that was where the white women's movement of that time was moving. And like, I had worked as a in a shelter, a battered women's shelter, answering the phone. The calls coming in from women at that time, it was very raw. You were hearing about the violence in their lives, and a certain number of white women went in the direction of the police. And working closely with the police and police patrolling areas and that kind of thing. And we were trying to shift them away from that. And this was very good anti-racist work, and is, I feel like, a more successful form, because it was directly saying, this is something you could do. Do you know what the police mean in the black community right now? They're an occupying army. Do you really want to work with them in your legitimate concern about violence, or is there another way? And it was raw, and it challenged white supremacy at that moment, where people were trying to figure out where to go with their own oppression and with their own issues. So one of the things I think about now is when we're looking at this